A very good evening to all of you. Welcome back to session 3, Alumni Ambassador Program, Phase 2, organized by Dr. NGP Institute of Technology, Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering. A warm welcome to our alumni, our principal, HOD, faculty members, and dear participants for today's session on a transformation co-branch to IT industry, presented by Ms. M. Satya, Senior of Software Engineer at Redbus Bangalore. Let me introduce to you our today's presenter, Ms. M. Satya of batch 2012 to 2016. Ms. Satya was one of the most active and talented students during the college days. She got placed in RoboSoft Technologies, New Udupi, Karnataka as a trainee software engineer. After a year, she was a software engineer, later on a senior software engineer in the same company and worked there for almost 3.5 years. Presently, she is a senior software engineer at Redbus Bangalore. Ms. Satya is an innovative developer and she had worked in all phases of the project, including design, development, testing and deployment. We are glad to have you here, ma'am. Without further ado, we will turn the time over to Ms. Satya.
Yes, Darshanika, thanks for the warm welcome note. And hello, guys. Very good evening to everybody. And adding to the Darshanika note, I would like to introduce my voice is clear, right? It's audible, right?
Yes, ma'am.
Guys, yeah, okay. So I'm from Coimbatore, and yeah, as you guys know, I studied in NGP, and it's been quite 4 years now. I chose EEE department. Basically, I was a bit interested in electronics and physics when I was doing 12th standard. So I thought I should do electrical and electronics related domain. So currently, I work for online bus booking firm, which is a product based company at Bangalore, and which is under GoMMT groups. And you all guys will be well aware of the application like Redbus, which is a bus booking platform, and Make My Trip, which is a trip booking platform, and GoIBibo, which is the flight ticket booking platform. So I work in mobile engineering team, which is purely a software development, where I can take care of designing the development and, you know, testing, maintenance in all the phases of software development. And I just want to be clear on things. So today I'm not going to teach you anything, but I'm just going to share my experience to all of you. Because after all these years, now I feel like I should have learned and know few things much before, actually. There were no proper guidance when I was doing, it's been 4 years, right, about the career in IT industries. That's why I wanted to interact with all of you guys. Okay, I'm gonna give you some suggestion to all of you. And basically, I have scored, when I was doing EEE, I was scored almost, I think, around 7.6 CGPA. I have attended many interviews, including electrical and IT companies such as Hexaware, Nippon Automobiles, and so many. When I was doing, when I was studying, there was an unanimous drive. I think still I believe that it's there for every, I mean, seventh semester, it's a kind of pool drive where companies like CTS, TCS, and Infosys hire the candidates. Even I was rejected because I got just 7.48 of average of 6 semester of CGPA. Just 0.02 mark, less than the benchmark, actually. I was so worried, and I was like, you know, little thought like, okay, I'll not get any opportunity. I lost, that's it. Because at that time, it was very difficult to get into a tier one companies. Now the opportunities are many. Many opportunities are there for the freshers, actually. So if you see, my journey is like, I'm from the middle class family where I have to go job and for paying my education loans and all. I have a sister, and my dad is working in Coimbatore Institute of Technology as a technical assistant in mechanical department. And people from society usually say to the parents, even to my parents, they say that she's just a girl. Why do you want her to study engineering? Just put her some basic UG courses so that money will be saved and you can get her married soon. And my dad always stood for me, my wishes and dreams. And I just wanted to take some part of the load from his shoulder. So that's why I started attending all the interviews and off-campus drive everywhere. Like, I never missed any chances. At the end of the graduation, I totally had 4 offers. So the first one is Hinduja Global Solutions. You guys will be aware of. It's IT industries, but I got placed in a BPO. BPO comes under IT industry, actually. And the second offer, I had EP Technologies, which is located at Chitra. And the third offer I got is Sunrise BizTech, which is located at Bangalore. And the role they offered me is like HR recruitment. And the fourth company is Robosoft Technologies. The role they offered for me is a software engineer, the trainee software engineer. I found that the fourth option was much better than the other options. So I joined as a trainee software engineer, and my interview was around 3 rounds, aptitude, logical solving. I think you guys started solving all those aptitude and logical solving. And the second round was a technical interview, and the third round was a HR interview. It was that simple. In technical round, I have clearly said to the interviewer that I know only very basic things in the programming. Since I'm from a EEE department, they just asked me a few questions like logical solving and the basic programming concepts, the array, how do you solve this problem? You can tell in words how you can solve the problem if you're not able to code also. Just logically how you can think. They just observed that. I was also like one among you guys, I think, because I never liked any computer science related subject during my college days. I just try to get some E grade. Actually, other subjects in electrical, I get some good, decent grades. But in computer science subjects, always I get E grade. And somehow I'll try to pass that subject for that particular semester. Then how do I got to learn a basic programming? We have studied data structures algorithm and object-oriented programming concepts, a lot of things. But do we really understand it when we were learning it? Actually, I was not understanding anything. Tree maps and a lot of things, binary search and all. I didn't understand anything. I just tried to, somehow I have to write the exam. That's why I was learning, not understanding things and, thinking in a proper way and solving the problems. I was not doing that. I learned it because we had a session during our final year of college days to solve simple problems. All department can, they are selecting few students and all department can participate. It really helped me actually. Try to do some pattern type programs, for example, print a star in one star in the first line, print 2 star in the second line, 3 star in the third line. Totally, you can print, your output should be in the fifth line, you should have a 5 stars, and totally, it should look like a pyramid shape actually. So these kind of programmings I was solving. So this is where I learned the basic looping programming. I didn't learn it when I had a subject actually. So this is basically they had given the session to the all students because campus recruitment started at the final year. So even everybody should know a little thing about the programming and all those things. Yes, and one more thing is like, I'm very active student, as Dakshina said, but I'm very, this kind of session and all is very new to me. I never come to the stage during my college days. I studied in a state board English medium school where English is not a medium to communicate with anybody, each other actually. I was very nervous, not so comfortable to talk in front of others. But I do MOC for various our EEE department events during college days. But actually, it's not a big deal to read something by seeing notes, So whenever they ask me to talk, I try to escape on topic. If they give on spot topic and all, I'll just try to escape from all those. But over the years, now I feel like I should not have done that actually. I suggest and request you guys to take this kind of opportunity to showcase your communication skill. Prepare the topic, just go and speak. You will learn something actually. You may rock it or you may do some mistake. But that's okay to commit mistake. You will learn to correct it. This really plays a good role in your communication skills. Don't think that people will criticize. Anyway, you have to face it one or other day. It's okay to be during college days. See, what happened in my career is like, I have joined at RoboSoft, which is located at Udupi, where I can't speak Tamil because nobody will understand it. I have to communicate in English or Kannada. I started speaking in English then because I have left out with no option. I have to communicate in meetings and with my colleagues and with my manager. I have to communicate. There is no other Kannada. I don't know completely. At least English, I know, hi, how are you, something. So I can manage with that. So sometimes people make fun of me. I just ignore. I don't take it personally. Over the years, I got to be a better in communication. I'm not a pro now also, but better than how I was earlier. And plan your career, basically. Why I'm saying is, along with my myself, there are 10 other engineers who got hired from the for the same company, actually. But few girls and boys, they didn't join because they said it's far from our state, it's a different state, and their parents were not allowing. I suggest you guys, don't be at your comfort zone. You are responsible for your career. Try to explain to your parents. Initial day of your career is very important. You have to travel miles if you get opportunities. Let's take this as a serious note, because getting an opportunity is very difficult. And if you are losing it because of some silly reasons, then it's gonna hamper your career. You are not sure next time you will get the same kind of opportunity. So initial days, you have to put your lot of hard work if you want to be successful on your profession. First 1 year, I was working as a trainee software engineer, where I got to learn a lot of tech stacks from seniors and colleagues. I got a good training from RoboSoft. I still remember during our probation period in my first company, I worked till 4 in the morning. Not only I, my complete batchmates worked till 4 in the morning, and again we came back around 7:38. Because we are zero in programming, we know that. We have to put effort to learn that. Okay. So I got some good amount of programming trainings and good seniors. For that, I'm really grateful for my first company, actually. And yes. So since you guys are a triple E students, you have a high chance of getting a job either in a electrical field or electronics or IT field. Don't think that you are a triple E student, so you will not understand programming and its programming is boring, and there is nothing like that. You have to practice in order to excel in that. If you see foreign countries, whereas India, we are not, you know, educating everybody codings and all, whereas in foreign countries, if you see even schooling kids and all, they learn coding irrespective of the branch they choose in the UG or PG. They have to, you know, do the coding to improve their analytical skill. We need to think deep to solve a problem. I suggest everyone should at least code once in their lifetime. So what is IT sector? Consider billing in a shop and something you are searching over the internet, paying money through UPI and storing all the Aadhaar card information of the citizens. Everything comes under the IT. IT is not something new to you, and it's already a part of your day-to-day life. So basically, IT sectors has many types: service-based company, product-based company, BPO, and if you say IT-enabled service, support and maintenance, and yeah. So if you see what service-based company does, like suppose you know CTS, TCS and all, service-based company. They get a projects from the client. They code for that. They'll finish the project. They'll get paid for it, and they'll give back to their clients, actually. They usually don't own the product. So suppose if I'm getting a project from Discovery, you all will watch Netflix or some Discovery apps, right? So CTS is getting a Discovery app project. They'll do it. They'll get paid for it, and they'll give to the client. Client is Discovery. So the Discovery owns the product. CTS will not own the product. So for example, I'm taking CTS and all just for understanding. So what is product-based companies such as Facebook, Myntra, Amazon? They mainly focus on improving their own products actually. If you see, Facebook has WhatsApp, Instagram, Facebook, all are under Facebook product. So they do create a different features to the users, and they try to focus more on their own product. And BPOs, you have to resolve and communicate customers' queries, and you have to be communicate between company and customer what's happening. You have to resolve the queries and all. And there is one more role, IT enabled service or support and maintenance field. There already the projects will be there, but suppose there is an issue suddenly, but you have given your project to the client, so now client has to take care. So he need a support team in order to fix those issues. So that's where the support roles comes in. Yes. So I know everybody uses online shopping. So that is nothing, e-commerce applications for shopping your shirts or shoes or anything. So I want to know, like, how many guys like know what is a technology behind that? You will be searching for a shirt. You will get all the list of shirts. You will pick one, and you will be placing the order, and you will be tracking your orders, and finally you will get your clothes. So have you ever thought how it works? Do you know how much engineering has been done for the system to work in such a way? So do anybody knows? Like, I'm asking a question. Any answers? No. Okay, I'll move on to the next thing. Okay, so what are the ways you can see the Amazon app? So either you can see it through Android app, Android mobile, or you can see the Amazon app in iOS device also. You can see it through a desktop or the laptops, where you can go to Chrome or Firefox or Safari, where you will be searching for Amazon, and you will land up in the Amazon website with apps or website. Consider these are the clients. Okay, consider you are the user, and you will be seeing only front end. So this is a client side, which you can see. No, that is just a client. That's a front end. So the people who work for developing the screen through which you can see all the content of Amazon is called the front end developers, actually, in IT field, in development, especially in software development. So where do you get all the contents from? Content in the sense I'm saying about you can able to see 10 shirts and 20 shirts and all, no? So different.
Database.
So okay, so yeah, you are where do you get it from? Do you have it all the contents in your mobile, or where it is stored actually? Is it inside your application in the device, if you are using a device? Actually, no. So whenever you search for Peter England shirt in your Android device, okay, Amazon application or Android, inside the Android device, so it will try to establish the connection to the server. So if you see, whenever you search the some Mac OS or laptop or anything, phone or anything, those things are called as a client. So when you want to search something, suppose you are entering Peter England shirt, it will try to establish the connections. So in order to establish the connection, what you required. So without internet, if you turn off the internet and search in Amazon, you just see whether you are able to get some contents. You will get it, but it's basically cached, but you will not get every content. Like suppose you are searching for Peter England, you will not get the Peter England because it's not cached anywhere. Okay, so basically you need an internet to connect to your server to get the information. And one more thing is a API, that is application programming interface. So these things and all, I'm damn sure this will be in your operating systems and your OOPs concepts and the data structures and everywhere you guys have seen it. But I'm not sure how much you guys have understand it, how the system actually works. So I just want to show you a model. This is a client and this is an API. You need an API to communicate to the server. Server, it has its own database. It can be a file storage or it can be a database. Server will hold the contents actually. So API plays a major role in getting the content from the server actually. So who is developing the API? Who will take care of the getting data from the server? Because you can see only this much. You can see the app, but what is behind it? You can able to see how the contents are rendering or how it is getting, how you are getting the content. Actually, no, right? So the people who works here, they are so-called backend developers actually. So when the user search for any information in the app, they have to use the API to get the information. API communicates to the server and gives the content. It has to communicate to the server and gives the contents back to your client. Client is nothing but your apps. Server, you don't think, what is server? Server is just an another machine. It's not your device. It's not a server. It's just an another machine where you have stored the data. Either it is a file storage or database. Now, is the data stored in a database? If you ask, I will say yes. Okay, it's stored in a database. So if you consider tomorrow, Peter England comes up with a new shirt designs. So they have introduced some new designs and new brands and all. So they'll create how you will get the new designs actually. So from tomorrow, these designs will be out. How you will get in the applications actually, how it's getting updated, who is updating in the server and all. So basically there is something called content management system. Okay, so they'll create a website which is only for the participating brand. I mean, suppose if Amazon is selling some product, there will be some brands like Peter England or it can be anything, any electronics items or anything. Those brands will request like, I want to participate in the Amazon to sell my own product. So only for those brands, they will give a website. Not everybody can access it. We cannot, as a consumer, we cannot access. As a user, we cannot access those website. Only they can access it. They will have own their access, you know, username, password and all. They can configure the cloth images and size, price and new thing. They can update it, they can delete it at any point. Next time when user search for it, okay, it will be anyhow, once the CMS updated, it will be in your database. So next time when you search, you will get it in a client. But consider if you have 500 cloths, you can manage it. If you have some 50,000 cloths, you want to delete something, you want to say, how will you do it? It's how will you do it? Like any clue, anybody, any guess? No, okay, fine. So I'll just go to this. Yeah. So there are some latest technologies, machine learning and, you know, artificial intelligence and all. So I'm not sure you guys are aware of this. Maybe we all know basically, but when I was doing college days, I was not aware. I'm the one who is raising the hand now. I don't know when I was doing college days. So I'll just tell you what it is actually. So machine learning is nothing but like, everybody uses Facebook here, I know. So whenever you upload a picture, the Facebook ask you to, you know, suggest you to tag yourself and your friend. Tag yourself, Satya, it will ask me. It's so-called automatic friend tagging suggestion. Have you observed this feature? Anybody observed this feature? How does it works? I think you all have observed, at least you can say yes, actually. No response. Guys, you are there. You are able to hear me?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Okay, yeah. It was there in the chat. Okay. So, So, how does it works actually? The technology behind this was a machine learning. So when you upload an image, the image is nothing but, it's a pixels actually. So whenever you upload an image for a first time, first few times, 10 image and all your 10, 15 images you are uploading, it's like Facebook teaches the machine to try to create a sequence of pixel in your image actually. So it tries to read it. So if you upload some 20 images or 50 images, from the next time onwards, it recognizes the images. It will, if even if you give an infinite pictures, it will find out where Satya is actually. So that's so-called machine learning. So they will code it in such a way, write an algorithm in such a way that a machine can recognize the particular images and all. So even you can ask me like, okay, after 10 years I'm uploading picture, so I become fat and all, I got a grayed out hair, how the machine now understand me, so how it will recognize me. So if you see that, still it will recognize you, that so-called artificial intelligence actually. And in machine learning, there are so many things are there. Like you might have recognized, even recently I have taught my mom, she doesn't know to type in English and all in Google. So I have taught her, you just, there is a Google Assistant, you just speak something, it will, recognize your voice, and you can just say fish curry and it will just take the words and it will convert it to English, and it will search for you. So that's a speech recognition, even a Google speech and all. So if you see the Google Translate and all, if you type water, it will give you in any languages. So these all are machine learning actually. So artificial intelligence is, it is nowadays giving a drastic change in technology fields, where it can be implemented to automate any system for more performance and efficiency. Consider you are sending an email in Google, okay? Lot of time I get a suggestion that, okay, type this as next word. If I am saying thank, and the next word it will say you. So it will suggest you actually. And feature like Siri from Apple and Alexa from Google works on the artificial intelligence, where a machine can have a human-like intelligence. The machine is trained to be like a human-like intelligence. So even if you might have noticed, like when you search, go to any website, there is a chatbot. So if I say chatbot, I'm not sure how many guys will understand. So if you go to any websites, you will get a dialogue suddenly. It will ask you a question. Hi, what do you want? May I help you? And you will say, yeah, I want to place this order, but will it delivered to my place? So due to this pandemic, a lot of location they were not delivering. You can communicate and it will answer to you as like a human is answering you. But behind the scenes, it is like artificial intelligence. Nobody is sitting there and responding to you, actually. So they have used the AI techniques, artificial intelligence techniques, to automate the customer support and assistance. That's the, main thing. So this is as like, say, mobile tries to communicate the server through the API. So you can think like, what is this API? Why she is showing API? So everything is a piece of code. So API also you can write a code, program only, nothing more than that. Even classes, functions and variables and all, the same thing. Even whatever you're seeing in the UI, that is also a co piece of code. Even the API, backend developers will a piece of code. Okay, and the server is a machine, as I said. It can be a cloud machine, it can be your next system. To you, it can be anything. So, example, you can see this is the user. Check the menu and make an order. Consider the user is your app. They are checking the menu and making an order. There is a waiter who takes the order to the kitchen and bring you the pizza from the kitchen. Okay, and it will deliver to you the table. So, consider this is like you are requesting for something, and your API is requesting to your server for whatever you are asking, and it will give back to you the response. Okay, and that response will be given to your delivered to your users. Okay, this is how the software system interacts with each other. So yeah, so I just want to know, I want to say basic concept we should know to crack IT company interviews. So I know, even I was a triple engineer, I was so adamant that I will not study any programming language, I will not like it. But it's okay to learn it. If you're not interested also, you can just learn one programming skill. And you know, I was also searching for electrical related jobs, and then at last I got into IT. I'm not saying there are no opportunity in electrical field, because I know there are people who is in a very good company and in a powerful position, even my friends. And so you will get, surely you will get, but there is no harm in learning a programming as like your second skills. Okay. So select a programming. I know you guys as students, you know C, C++, Java. These words only you might have heard. There are a number of programming languages that are there, like Kotlin, Swift, Objective-C, Python, .NET, Golang, Erlang. Lot of languages are there. But in college days, we study C, C++, maximum to Java. So take that Java is somewhat latest comparing to C, C++. Take Java programming language. Obviously, I know everybody know how to write class and all, pakka, because I was also knowing it when I was in your stage. So learn how to create class, why main method is always being called in the class. First method is a main method being called. How to write if and else loop. You know, if and else loop is nothing, OR gate and AND gate, how you have done in electricals and electronics, right? So it's not something new to you, and you can do it in a better way actually. And how the for loops works, how the iteration happens and all, and the proper usage of the data structures. Data structures is a very powerful thing. Anybody can code, it's very easy, but people who know to use which data structure to solve this problem, because can solve the problem in I have array list is also a data structure, right? Array list, linked list, and we have many more, like so many things are there. So you should know, for this problem I can use a tree set only, because tree set removes the duplicate entries. For this value I should use array list only. So you should know which one you should choose. For that, you should know at least a basic understanding. Just go through it. It's not like you have to code completely and all. Just go through the concept behind that. And that, you know, that gives you the efficient problem solving skill actually. So these are the important things. And I have suggested so many programming language. So I said, like, don't try to learn everything. Don't try to cover up more programming language and all. And it will really, it is not going to help you anywhere. Because if you give an interview, the interviewer will ask you to solve a problem in any language. He don't have any problem if you solve in C, C++, or Java. But he want to know how you're solving the problem. That's it. So he will not see the fancy code. See, you can refer this, the right side one is a Kotlin, which is a, you know, fancy code. A function can be called, like, you can see the last function, fun main. But here you will have public, static, void, main, and all those things. And the method also, if you see, private, function, get, user, profile name, string, return type is string. Here, if you see, private, string, and all. So it is little old code, Java. Whereas Kotlin is like little fancy thing, but everything is same. If you learn one programming, you can learn any programming easily. That's not a big thing. That you can do it once you enter into an IT industry. But as of now, just focus on Java and learn the data structures, basic concepts, like not an algorithms and all, just at least an array list, linked list, how it works, how to solve small problems and all. That really helps you. Yes, learn everything online actually. When I was doing college, I was not so aware. I'm not such kind of person always use, you know, phone. For chatting, we use actually everybody, but not for learning purpose. We always go for books only. We will never use a mobile so much. But after this 4 years, I know now, even if I have any doubt, I'll just go to Google and I'll just search. You will get n number of good technical stuffs over there. You can see, you can read it, and you can see, you can take a notes of this Code Academy, Udacity, Udemy, Geeks for Geeks, Lead Code, and all these all are a website where you can learn the coding basic tutorials. They will teach you nine classes means what, 9 to 10 classes, 1 hour a day. It's not a big thing. If suppose you're going to get an IT industry job, suppose you're getting, that's a great thing, no? So it's not like going to create any harm to you just spending 1 hour in that. Really, people think like, oh no, I'm not interested and all, but actually it helps them in many ways. So you can go to these kind of websites for learning codings. It's actually that you don't need to pay and all. It's a free courses are there. Just see the free courses. That's enough. Lead Code and all always give, you know, some problem solving contest and all they will conduct where you can learn a lot of coding actually. And I would like to convey a message to all of you. Even though I am a triple E student in my first company as well as my current company, I have stayed almost 3.5 years in my first company. You know, that's I have learned a lot of things there actually. I have moved to the second company. But one thing was constant was like I was always getting appreciated from my manager. They trust the work I do. And they trust I'll do a better and faster over other engineers. Other engineers in the sense I'm including even CSE IT students. I'm not dominating or doing something like that, no. But triple E is not, you don't think it's a barrier to, you know, for the IT profession actually. You will get recognized for your work actually and efficient programming, how you are doing and how you are creating an impact on a system and how you are solving a day-to-day user's problem by your coding skills. You don't have to be a CSE and IT engineer to be successful in your IT profession. So consider an example, how will you resolve the problems in day-to-day life in IT? Just for example, I'll tell you, since I will tell about my experience in Redbus actually. So, you know, this pandemic is a user is not ready to travel anywhere. And I'm working in a bus booking platform. People are very scared to, you know, travel in the bus because all the other people also travel along with them. And they are not ready to touch any object when they move because they are scared I will get a, you know, virus and all those things. So we have come up with something called contactless QR based verification. So user can book their ticket. They will get a QR code generated for the particular ticket. So when you travel, you can go and sit in your bus. Just conductor will come. Usually you have to give the money to him. He has to verify or you have to give a sheet and all those things. But he can just, you know, you will have a QR code. He will have his own app. He'll just come and you have to show your QR code in the phone. He will not even touch, just he'll scan it. And he will get all the informations about you and about your bookings and where from where to where you're traveling. This is how you will solve the day-to-day problems. Even if you see Guaibibo flight bookings, where web check-in and all is there. Usually, I know 2 years back, I traveled in flight. So where, you know, if you enter to the airport, they will ask so many questions. You have to show ID card and you have to, you know, stand in the queue and all those things. Nowadays, everything is reduced. You just show the QR code. They will, you know, check you really have a valid ticket and you, it's the boarding pass for you and what is your name, all the details, then you can just fly. Nobody, you know, interrupt you in the middle and nobody will come near to you. You don't have to get scared. So yeah, this is some examples of how you will be solving your day-to-day problems. And I know there will be a lot of confusions and all in your mind going on, like a pandemic, a lot of hit for industries and markets are down. But if you are really good at what you are learning, I'm sure you all will get a job. If you feel that you are lagging on something, either it is a communication or technology, please do practice. Nobody is, you know, born with talent. You have to practice in order to excel it. I hate coding when I was doing college days, as I said. But now I just, you know, it's ulta. I just love solving the problems. I'm happy with what I'm doing now. It's not like I want to go to IT industries because it was not decided. I was also searching a job in electrical industry only. But I got into IT industries. But I was okay to grab the opportunities instead of, you know, staying back so I will get job. I'm not sure whether if I lost these opportunities, would I get an opportunity or not in any other sectors. I'm not sure about it. But after that, I have joined here. After that, I never tried for any other job for almost 3.5 years. And either it is a electrical or IT field, you should be happy for what you're doing actually. But you should be always open to learn new things and do practice it constantly, and it will really enhance your skills. IT is also not so easy actually. I am into a development actually. So if you see, I have to learn every year. I'll constantly learn something new. Every year the technology comes, every year some new updates comes. I have to keep learning things. So if you have eager to learn the stuff, and you know, even I said I don't know English, but I learned it when I moved to the place where I have to speak. As I said, I don't know coding, but I have to learn it because I thought that's a better opportunity I can take. So wherever you go, whatever opportunity they give, try to do your best. That's what, you know, required actually. And I have bagged, you know, awards and appreciations and all those things in my previous company as well as the current company. Do you guys think you cannot? Because I'm damn sure you all can. And yeah, that's it. Thanks for the opportunity for interacting with all of you guys. And if you have any queries and all, you can ask to me. I'm ready to explain you actually.
Thank you, ma'am. And participants, if you have any questions, please type your questions into the chat box.
I hope at least you guys got something what I try to explain you, because when I was studying, I didn't get this much overview, because nobody can tell you this. Since I have been in IT industry, so I know how the system works. Otherwise, for the engineers to, you know, think about the architecture and system design and all, it's really difficult to either to teach or, you know, to tell you guys. So you can ask me any doubts if you have, if anybody is interested in coding now, because I was not interested, but I hope somebody will be interested here. So let me know. I will suggest you where you can find the tutorials, where you can learn the things, and it will really help you. So any doubts, just because I have taken IT related stuff, I think you guys are not asking me, I guess.
Darshanika, I can find any questions from chat box.
Yes, ma'am, we are just learning the basics now.
Okay.
And, could you please
give few websites where we can find the programs or something
Yes.
like that?
Yeah, sure. So you can check for Geeks for Geeks. So there you can find lot of tutorials. They will teach you from the very basic thing. There is a beginner and advanced courses also there. It's free actually, free of cost. You can go and check any programming and you can learn that. But I suggest you guys to learn Java first and understand the complete thing. Later, learning other languages is not a big deal.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Yes, yeah. Thank you. All the very best for all of you guys. Hope, I think this time also an university drive should come.
Thank you, Satya. Okay. This time, this final year, a lot of students placed in some reputed companies like HCL and other companies also.
Yeah, good to hear, sir.
Okay.
Ma'am, you have something here from Kiran. If I say that entering into IT field after being an electrical engineer was a bad idea, can you defend it?
Actually, no. Initial first 1 year when I was working in RoboSoft, I worked really hard to learn the things because, as I said, I don't know anything in programming. I don't defend it. It's your personal choice. You can, if you are getting four offers, it's you who has to choose which opportunity you want to go. Either it is an electrical or it is an IT field. So at last, you all gonna be an engineer. Even suppose we have to, you know, design a robot or something. Electrical engineer will be there. Even electronics engineers will be there to connections, and even you know CSE engineers will be there for programming. So at last, we all are engineers, right? So I don't defend it actually. That's a personal their actually wishes. Like if they wanna go IT, they can go. But there is no harm in going. You can also, you know, be successful in your IT profession.
Okay, ma'am. There's another question. How you are handling the pressure in IT industry?
So, handling the pressure in the IT industries, yeah, it will be there initially when you start your career for some 1 year and all, because, you know, senior says that you don't know this and all. And you will feel so embarrassed that what he is asking me, you don't know this. Yeah, I don't know. I'm from Tripoli. I don't know. But I was constantly learning the things. And the same, you know, seniors has appreciated me for, you know, the works I have done. So pressure was there. When you don't know the things, you will feel so pressurized and all. But if you get to know the things, then you will be in a safe place. So it's very easy to handle the pressure. I mean, initial days, you will be getting such kind of stress and all.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah.
Yes, ma'am, there's another one.
Yes.
How did you move from code to IT suddenly? Didn't try any other code texture?
So, Sanjay Kumar, actually, So actually, I have tried in all the sectors. It's not only, you know, when if you see in IT industries, even now, I can see, except civil engineer, I have seen all the engineers, like mechanical engineers are working along with me in my team, electrical engineers, everybody is working along with me in the team. So I don't think so. It is like suddenly I have moved and all. I tried a lot and I end up with this option. So I was happily taken the opportunities what came to my way.
Okay, ma'am. It looks like we've covered all the questions. And thank you, ma'am. And thank you, everyone, for joining us today.
Yes, yeah, surely one day I'll come to college and meet all of you guys. I hope this pandemic situation and all should, you know.
Thank you. Sure, Satya. Thank you, Satya. It's a wonderful speech.
Thank you, sir. And I'm very happy that I could, you know, communicate something to my juniors. And
sure.
Yeah. Surely, I want to meet all the staff also. It's been a long time. I mean, it's been a long 4 years, I think. So, I should come and meet everybody.
Expecting, Satya. Okay, Dashnika, you can...
Yes, sir. Even we are very eager, ma'am. And our next session will be presented by Ms. M. Nandini, an alumni of 2011 to 2015 batch. Presently, she is Associate Cognizant Technology Solutions on the topic, Why Should a Core Engineer Learn Analytical and Programming Skills? And once again, thank you everyone for your active participation. We will see you tomorrow. Bye.
Dashnika, 1 minute, okay. I just want to tell you one thing. Prepare a good resume and upload in Naukri and LinkedIn. I guess you people know how Naukri and LinkedIn and all works, where you will get n number of opportunities. So do that, because when I was doing college days, I was not aware of this Naukri and LinkedIn and all. Now everybody knows it. So I request you guys, I am suggesting you to use those website. It's for professional queries and all. Really, there are a lot of people are there, electrical, IT, civil, mechanical, a lot of people are there. They'll really help you all for finding out the good job for you.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah.
Thank you, ma'am.
Yeah, fine.
Thank you, Satya. Thank you all.
Yeah.